Yay, we're live. Hey, everybody. Let's see if I can find where we are over here. So I'm Facebooking you up at the same time. So Caitlin, how are you today? Can you hear me? Oh no, we're having sound difficulties. And Caitlin's frozen, and we're frozen. Give us a second, guys. We're having a few technical difficulties. We're live in action today. Live on location. And I think Caitlin froze up. We're going to try it again, guys. Give us a second. All right, we're recording. Let me go over to Facebook. Live on Facebook. Try this again. Technical difficulties. What are you gonna do?
Pool day.
It's all good. Give us a second, guys. We're going live in a second here. I'm gonna type my little thing in again. Okay, live. Poolside. Well, one of us is poolside. Shifting into purpose. I love it. Impromptu. Okay, we're going live. It's thinking. Guys, hang tight. We're going live across our platforms.
Yeah.
Chat with Miss Caitlin. Oh, I can see us. Good. Yay. So we lost Caitlin. We're back. We were having technical difficulties. The universe wants to talk about shifting into purpose today, and then it froze up Caitlin and dropped her off. So we'll see if we have better luck this time.
Yes.
Yes. So you said your iPhone literally said...
It did.
It froze up, right?
iPhone needs to cool down, and it just shut down. And I was like, this is really hot here if it's really needing to take a break.
Tell everybody where you are today.
Well, I feel like I'm in paradise. I'm actually outside of Phoenix, Arizona, in my neighborhood pool, and it's absolutely beautiful. Let me see. Can I change the camera around?
I think so. Let's see.
Yep.
Enjoying
some beautiful, beautiful sun rays and working.
I love it. Yes.
I love it.
You get to work from anywhere, which is the greatest, right?
That's right. As long as I've got my phone, my laptop, I'm in business.
Yay. So we're actually, this is total impromptu live stream today. Caitlin, for those of you who don't know, is on my amazing team. She's on the Careers on Vacation team. She's one of our amazing enrollment coaches, but she just, which is not why I have her on the show today. I just wanted to, she went through a huge life shift recently. And so I wanted to talk to her about how did that feel to pit you? Tell everybody what happened, first of all, and the shifting you've been going through the last few months.
Yeah, I've had a lot of change, a lot of shift.
That too. You went through a life shift recently.
Do you have some echo?
Sorry, I got rid of it. The wrong button. Take it from the top. Technical is really trying to break us down today.
The last couple of months, I made a huge leap of faith and decided to pick up and move, because why not? You know, I wanted to be closer to some people in my life that mean a lot to me, and just picked up and moved. And that's the beauty of being an entrepreneur and a business owner. You can do that. You can create those options for your life. And I'm not going to lie, it was fearful. You know, anything that is huge change like that. I mean, I moved 2,000 miles from where I had really been comfortable living.
Yeah.
So 2,000-mile move, that's a big move. And leaned into that fear, leaned into that uncomfortableness. And I'm like so happy. This is week two, being outside of Phoenix, Arizona, and absolutely love it. We have not had a cloudy day yet.
and you were in Ohio, right?
Yep.
The snow and the whole thing. So yeah.
They might have one sunny day a week. And now I'm like sunny day all the time, which might get a little old when it's, you know, 100 degree plus days, but
yeah,
I'm embracing it, embracing the change. I'm excited. leaning into living my best life. So.
And I love that so much. And you know, because we had the whole team out here at Austin a few months ago, and we really got clear on our company values. And one of the values was model the travel lifestyle. Like, yes. Our staff can work from anywhere. And so when I heard you were moving, I was like, well, yeah, that's awesome. She can work from anywhere. Who cares? Right? So it wasn't like that piece of it, I'm sure. But still, to pick up to go 2,000 miles is crazy, because you have your fur baby, too, who had to go.
My fur baby. I know. Right. He went on his first hike this past weekend. So we went up to North Arizona, and it was like 75 degrees. It's crazy how much temperature difference can be from like the desert to North Arizona. We went camping, and he went on his first hike. He absolutely loves it.
Aww.
Loves his new life.
I love it. You're like, we both love it. It's amazing. We have a few people saying hello. Hey, Kathy. Hey, Ann. Hey, Stacy. And we have a lot more on watching us live. Tell us what, like, for those of you watching, tell us the scariest thing you've ever done. Like, just like Caitlin just picked up and decided, I'm going to move. Now's the time. What's a time in your life that you like leaned in and did something scary? Because I know it's like so, it's that thing where like, you know what you want to do, you know what you want to have, but it feels so big at the time. And then of course now when you're poolside and the, you know, everything's arrived and everything's, it makes it easier to go, oh yeah, it was the best thing I did. But like, if you rewind and go, kind of like when we sold our business and we decided to move to Austin, kind of the same thing, it was really scary. I'd love to hear from you guys. So if you're watching us over on Facebook Live, tell us what your, something scary you did in your life, and if it turned out good, bad, or otherwise for you, we want to hear about it. But I was watching like this documentary yesterday on, I don't know if she's a coach or a motivational speaker, but she said something that really resonated with me. And she said, when you are in resistance to yourself, it is like living in hell. And I was like, whoa, that was like a light bulb, because it's one of those things where how long have you wanted to make the move? How long have you wanted to do something different? How long have you wanted to, whatever someone's crazy thing is, right? And when you're in resistance because it's status quo, because it's comfortable, because it's not the unknown, how long do you stick there in that resistance to yourself? So I don't know. I mean, what are your thoughts on that, Caitlin? I know this is totally live, by the way, guys. We did not pre-talk. I'm like, let's log on, show everyone that you're at the pool today and have a little chat.
Yeah, no, that totally resonates with me too, because when we're in a place of that resistance, I feel like it affects our spirit and our physical health. You know, I have anxiety when I'm going against what my spirit's really telling me to do. You know, I feel like I begin to question every move that I make, like, oh my gosh, am I doing the right thing? And you know, it's almost like we get into this place of people pleasing. And what's the best decision for my family? What's the best decision for my partner, whatever?
Yeah.
And, or my job or my career move. I climbed a corporate ladder for 10 years and quickly realized that I can either continue to do that. Yeah. Have a ceiling income cap, make a lot of money. Or I can lean into that resistance, that different, and choose a different life for myself. And I'm not going to say it's easy. Yeah. You have to really decide to show up for yourself, really decide to make that conscious decision that you want a better life,
mm-hmm.
and you want more.
Yeah.
That doesn't mean income. That just means more out of life, more for yourself. And yeah. So, you know, looking back 3 years ago when I made that decision to step out of corporate America, I would have never dreamed to be sitting by the pool. You know, it's like, if we sat by the pool, we're like, I have to take a vacation day or something, you know?
Yeah.
So, you know, to make that choice 3 years ago that was resistance of, I fought it for months and months and months,
mm-hmm.
finally just said, I'm doing it. I'm going to do it. And I didn't know the future.
Yeah.
But I'm creating it, and I'm continuing to create it, and it's exciting.
And that's that shifting into purpose. Like, the minute you make the decision, don't you feel like a shift in, like, your energy, enthusiasm? What did that feel like to make that decision where you're like, it's scary, but I'm doing it, boom?
Yes. Yes. And that energy, it's almost like that release of like all that tension, all that anxiety, all that fear. I mean, there's days that you might still have fear. Those are gremlins.
Yeah.
And you're going to work through those, and you're going to surround yourself with powerful entrepreneurs and leaders who are running their own businesses, being badass women, and they're going to keep encouraging you. And so that's going to be a point where you're like, on those days, they're like, oh my gosh, did I make the right decision? Or can I do this? You absolutely can. You absolutely can. There's nothing different between Cyndi, myself, our team, than you. Anyone can create their best life.
And then you see the people sitting next to you that have been in the business for years, right? And then they're part of your new community, which is amazing. And I want to go back to like what you said at the beginning, where you're like, you know, I was feeling sick, or I was having that anxiety. That's what it feels like to be in that discord, to be in that resistance with yourself. Because I remember my husband, like, he was in corporate, and I mean, everyone's probably heard my story. Like, I had a panic attack, and we had this other business. It was huge business, and people are like, you can't get rid of that business, you're crazy, blah blah blah. So it was a very successful business, but I just hated it, and it was against what my life's purpose was. And so I had this whole thing where my body did get sick, it did break down, but it was the catalyst for doing something new. And with my husband, he's all like, you know, VIP football player in high school and the whole thing. And when he had this one certain job in corporate where it was just tugging like on his soul. This is before we started our original other business. And he would get sick like once a month, and he's like super healthy guy, but it was just, I think, a buildup of like not doing what you love every day and not feeling inspired. And just, I think that's what it feels like to sit in that muck, to like sit in that, you're existing, not living kind of thing, right? I want to stop real quick because we have a couple notes on here on the feed coming through. Kathy says, scariest thing she ever did was took the plunge for careers on vacation. And guess what? She's doing great. Good for you, Kathy. We love having you in the mastermind. Kathy's amazing. And she's going through a big shift of, you know, working herself out of another business and getting into the travel industry and doing that whole thing. So she hired us to teach her how to do it the right way so she can be on the outward right with Caitlin. Crystal saying hello. Crystal's a former grad. Hey, Crystal.
Hey,
Crystal. Kathy says she's heading back to California from Lake Havasu. Yay, that's awesome. So guys, if you guys are just joining, tell us something scary that you've done to get out of this muck status quo anxiety place in the resistance to yourself to shift into, doesn't have to be opening a travel business, but what did you do to shift? How does that, we're getting through like the feelings of what it feels like. Cause yes, it feels scary. And yes, it feels all this stuff until you make the decision. And then the energy like relaxes a little bit and you get your, you can kind of come back into yourself. It's almost like feeling like, I don't know if it's a flower blossoming or like you're coming back alive. Like when I finally made the decision, and kind of like you, like I was totally unsure. I'm like, my parents were like, Cyndi, you're crazy. You've had this other business for 10 years. You guys have been making this great abundance. Like people thought we were nuts to walk away from this other business. But I'm like, look, I don't care if it burns down tomorrow. I'm not doing it anymore. I'm quitting. And my husband's like, well, we can't quit. We have 50 employees. Let's do this the right way. But it's from that point on where I released it and said, I really don't care what happens because I'm going to do travel full time and I'm going to do everything that I have done in this other business. And my travel business is going to be even bigger and better. And I just took on a new mindset. And from that day where I just, and to my husband's credit, he was like, all right, let's figure out a way. Like if he would have given me resistance too, it may have been more difficult. But I was like, holy crap, he believes in me. Like, let's do it. Like now's my chance to get out of here and live my dream. And it was so scary because we have kids, we have a mortgage, we had two nice cars, we got all that stuff that everybody else has. And it's that something happens in your energy. And when you, like you said, you have to show up for yourself where you say, I'm going to do X, Y, Z, whatever your X, Y, Z thing is. I don't know, maybe you want to be a gardener or a chef or, you know, own a restaurant or have a travel company. That's what we do, right? So, but whatever your thing is, like the minute you go, I heard this somewhere too this week, your why becomes bigger than your worry.
Yes.
Your why. Oh, I just got chills. Oh, I got chills. You see the locks?
Yes.
Your why becomes bigger than your worry. And if you can sit in that worry place forever, and that's fine, but your choice is like, do you want to live a vibrant life? Do you want to live or do you want to exist? So if you can get your why to be bigger than your worry, that's when you can take action and make change.
That's awesome.
That's my coaching piece of the day today. Yeah. So Caitlin is just one of my team members. She's poolside today. And most of you guys that follow this channel, you're usually following because you're here for travel advice and all that good stuff. But that's the beauty of whether you're brand new in this business and you want to work from anywhere, like Caitlin, take your laptop and be traveling and booking. You know, first of all, if you're not in the industry at all, there's amazing perks in this industry. And if you're growing your business or getting ready to grow a team, that's what's so attractive about being in this business is you can run it from home or while you travel. And I had a great conversation with someone else last week, and they're like, I didn't realize I could take my kids with me traveling. And I was like, wow. And they're like, I've been watching you, and you're here with your son and here with your daughter and here with your kids. And I took that for granted, because since they were born, they've been going on so many vacations. Like, my kids think it's normal to like go to Disney 3 times a year and do all the other crazy stuff we do. But if you guys are wanting to have that reconnection, I think, with your family, and you have that passion for travel, like, don't let kids be the thing that said, we're getting ready to go. Caitlin's by the pool and I'm super jealous, but we're getting ready to go in a couple weeks. We're heading to Disney for a month, y'all, like 31 nights, I think we're saying, because we can just take our laptops and that's our business. Like, how crazy is our life? And like, if you think back to corporate days, oh, you're so right. That would never, you'd never be able to do that in corporate. I love it. So Caitlin, what are your plans as you move forward?
What did you say?
What are your plans as you move forward in this cool new place?
I mean, Arizona is absolutely beautiful. There's, the rest of the day, I'm going to pretty much work from the pool. Just soak up some sun rays, work on this tan, help change some lives. That's our job.
That's right. We get to help people change our lives. We have like the greatest jobs on the planet. People are always, Cyndi, show me how to do what you do.
What are you doing the rest of the day? And it's like sitting by the pool, changing lives.
That's right.
I do. And it's just awesome. Absolutely love it. So, but I think you're absolutely right. You know, it's having that first belief. Mm-hmm. Like that vision board belief that I can go to Disney for 34, 35 nights and work, or I can take my family around the world on a tour and still work a business. You know, I think it's believing that it's possible, because it absolutely is possible. The first step is belief, and that second step is mindset, like leaning into, I want a better life. I want to change, and then taking action. So, you know, that third step is really taking action to partner with someone, to find that group of people that's going to support you in that next step and that action step. And I love that we are such an awesome team. And we're changing people's lives, making those 5-figure businesses. So
we are. And it's one of those things where, like, we're not, you know, because I flew everyone down here to Austin. And I'm like, yes, we have all these case, like, go to YouTube and check out our dozens and dozens of case studies. We have like 10 or 15 case studies that aren't even out there yet, because they're just so far back in editing. Like, we have so many more coming. It's insane. But the thing about it is like, what I said at the meeting, we're not going to just sit on our laurels. Like, yes, we're getting these amazing results, but how do we make the program even bigger? How do we make it even better? And how do we get better? How would we get even more results for our clients? And Caitlin, Christine, Stephanie, my daughter interns for us during the summer. We had the whole team, Natalie, we had our team there. Marcy was virtually from Michigan, but we were all there to say, what else can we do? And so we have like the crazy coolest things happening this month, y'all. And for those of you who are already enrolled this summer, you're getting this all, we didn't even sell it to you, and you're just getting all this cool stuff that you didn't even know was coming. So kudos to you for leaning in. Look at how the universe is showing up to support you. But for those of you who have been like thinking about it, like, read the comments coming in right now. So we have Oh my gosh, you're going too fast where I can't read it. Anne says, will you please adopt me and at least tell me how to go to Disney for a month? Yes, Anne, take our masterclass, which is totally free, careersonvacation.com. /masterclass, totally free resource to help you get started. And then when you're ready to get serious about living this lifestyle, careersonvacation.com/ready now. You can talk to Caitlin at the pool today, or I don't know, you might be booked up later today, but you can talk to Caitlin or one of our other enrollment coaches. The comments are going too fast. There was another good one. Crystal, who's a former grad, had some stats on there. Let me see if I can get back to it and read it. And she was talking about how Careers on Vacation was scary for her, but how great it's going. I don't know if I can find it. I can't get back. Christy says scariest thing was quitting her job last month and going through COV and starting her travel business. Christy's getting ready to graduate too. She's amazing, has been through the program. Margie says, I'm sitting at my corporate desk feeling the kick in the pants to get moving and make it happen. Yes, I love that. And there's more in the feed. We have a lot of our grads tuning in and current COV, and we're sold out. Like, I think we had one person who this morning shifted around, so I think we only have like one spot left for June. Part of that is we also have a TV show that goes on Roku and Amazon that just started last month. And so it's crazy. It's been so crazy around here lately. But I want to encourage you guys, like, you can have this lifestyle. And I get, like, Caitlin and I get excited about it because we're living it. And like, after a while, you do take it for granted a little bit. Like, yeah, like, I just said to my husband, let's go, maybe we should go to Florida for a month. And he's like, okay, because my husband works full-time in the business too. That we've grown it to that level where it's a family business. My daughter interned, my son has his own YouTube. Like, it's the whole thing, right? But why can't you? So many people always ask themselves, like, you know, how could I, or how could that work, or blah, 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 instead of saying, why not me? Like, why couldn't it be me? If you get the right roadmap and get the right help, I don't recommend that you take the number of years of mistakes I had to make getting it into a routine and doing the DIY version of putting it together, because it will take 10 years. I mean, it could take a long time. I still have clients that come to us that have been in the business 10, 15, 17. I even have some 20 year in, where they come back and go, oh, I would have had this 5 years ago. If I would have had this 10 years ago, I could have been so much more profitable so much faster. Because I've trained thousands of people, and in the Careers on Vacation program, we have it really dialed into what works in an online market for today, for online marketing. So I'm going to just encourage you guys, do the free masterclass. It doesn't cost you anything. We put that together as an advocacy project to help everyone on their journey. And then book your call with Caitlin, so you can start booking trips and start, you know,
getting. Absolutely love it. So, yes.
So good, right? I get too excited. I know I do. But I want people to like feel like, I want to get it.
Yes.
If I could go back and shake my own shoulders, I did a post last week, right, about like how I almost didn't. I always had a dream of having a travel school since I was like in my 24, 25. And I flaked out. Like, I didn't believe in myself enough. And imagine where I would be had I started it way back then and skipped over all that crap of, you know, sitting in it. But that's okay, because wherever you are, first of all, it's never too late.
That's right.
And it's never too late to make a change and to be the rock star that you want to be.
Absolutely. You know, I talked to someone last week who is nearing retirement, and she said that it's eaten at her soul for years. She said even back when she was in her 20s that she wanted to be a travel agent. She wanted to, you know, have a life traveling. But she followed that career path because that's, you know, what everybody kind of told her to do. And that's what was safe and comfortable. And she raised her family. Now she's a year out of retirement. And she's like, now is my time. You know, now her time to take her life and what she wants to do, invest in herself, invest in growing the life that she wants. But you know what? Why wait till retirement? Yeah. Why wait till you're in your 60s? Yeah. You know, do it now. create that life that you dream of now.
Yep. And we, guess what? We have college students going through the program too, because they're like, college isn't teaching me how to run a business. They're teaching me. And look, I'm all for education. I think education is awesome, but you don't have to go for 4 years before you sell your first. In fact, if you go for 4 years, travel and tourism, you're not going to graduate knowing how to run an online travel business. So we still have people that go through that program and then they're like, oh my gosh, maybe I should have just done this, because it's so much more than a travel school, right? It's, yes, you're going to learn how to be an agent, but we teach you the architecture of setting up your business. And that's hard. Like, if you've never done it, I get why people are scared. It's easy for us because we're, you know, we're helping hundreds of people a year go through this process and do it the right way. But it's kind of like, this will be my last funny analogy I give you guys, but this occurred to me the other day because I was trying to teach my son, like, how to bake, he wants to learn how to bake a cake, right? So I'm like, okay, so as I was doing this process, I remembered my grandma and how she taught me how to crack the eggs and how you have to sift the flour, like from scratch. I'm not talking like Betty Crocker out of the box, right? And it just made me think, like, if you just get thrown into a kitchen and you've never baked a cake before, like, how's that going to turn out if you don't have the measurements, if you don't know how to put it together, if you don't know how long to cook it for, if you don't know how to do all those pieces, your cake is going to be like, versus if you have grandma's recipe and someone has walked you through it, me being grandma, I guess, in the Christmas world, but walking you through, here's what to do when, here's how to do it, here's how long to cook it. Guess what happens at the end? You have a beautiful cake. And your whole family can eat. You can support your family, right? So I don't, I had to get these funny
That's
analogies.
That's awesome. But that's a great analogy. Right? I love that.
Because we always call it a roadmap, but it really is, it's like a recipe to success in this industry, which is why we're getting all this crazy press and we're growing. If some of you haven't already, like that's the other thing I do want to say, like, when it comes to the mastermind, all this, we haven't even told you guys about the new stuff. We did announce the new mentors we have coming on. That doesn't mean you necessarily get less of Cyndi. You get more experts in our program now. So we have three experts we've just brought on, an expert in curating branding. We have an expert in running Facebook ads and promotions, and we have another expert in mindset. So they're going to be integrated in to just add extra levels of support. And we're doing more modules on how do you book crews? How do you book? So we have all this new optional classes for our clients to go through. And that was part of that brainstorm we did a few months ago. So, and here's the thing, guys, like the program price is going up because we have to pay experts now. Like that doesn't come for free, but it will still be way less than you'd ever be able to go out and hire this team on your own. But our rates are not going to go up for like maybe 15 days, 20 days. So it's going to happen sometime in July. But even if you want to go, if you want to attend the program in July, August, September, October, we're taking deposits to get your enrollment in. And we also have plans now. We're making it super easy. So if you sign up in the next few weeks, you're going to get all that stuff before the price increase goes in. So if you haven't already, what are you waiting for? Book your call with Caitlin. We'll talk to you guys. But Caitlin, any other words of advice or encouragement for our awesome viewers today?
Don't wait another day of resisting what your heart's telling you to do. Lean into that, because the second that you do and the second that you actually embrace that fear, oh my gosh, like things open up that you've never dreamed are going to open up. So do it. Say yes to yourself. Say yes to that life that you want to build.
We just had another grad post best decision ever. So like, if you guys don't have to listen to us, like just go listen to our amazing community. Cause after they graduate, they go into our grad group and we still do retreats and all kinds of fun stuff. And Stacy says, in the back of my head, you were always there saying, I'm your biggest cheerleader. Thank you, Cyndi, for teaching me what I needed to start my business. That's Stacy. Yeah, and that's, like, I'm super transparent. So is Caitlin. Like, everyone that works for my company, just, we are who we are. Like, we're going to be there for you and help you every step of the way. So it doesn't have to be scary. Like, I know getting out of the is scary, but and there is a case study we filmed last week. It's not even out live yet, but she said something so key. She's like, I was so nervous. My palms were sweating. I didn't know, but she's like, I knew I had to do it. And she's like, and the minute I got on that first call, I was like, okay, I just all the way, because she realized, like, this is the real deal, I'm gonna get help, and then she got excited, and that's when, like, the big movement can happen. So, Kaylin, I'm gonna let you get back to the swimming pool. I'm super jealous.
Love it.
But we'll have to do this again when I'm in Florida. Like, we'll have to do the pool to pool. So pretty.
It's so pretty, and this is, like, my backyard.
It is. That is so great. I love it so much.
I love it.
That's amazing. Well, you enjoy the pool. I'm going to be working with our amazing clients this afternoon. I'm actually doing a mastermind call this afternoon with all of our students. So we'll be doing that later. All right, love. I love you so much. We'll talk soon.
Bye.
Bye, lady. Take care.